We're going to be talking about Foursquare Rum Distillery, and this is one of only four distilleries on the island of Barbados. Barbados, arguably being the birthplace of rum as we know it today, is one of only two distilleries that are still owned by Barbadian families. Currently under operations by Mr. Richard Seal, who is the fourth generation of his family to own and operate R.L. Seal & Co. and Foursquare Rum Distillery. He was one of the first people inducted to the UK's Rum Hall of Fame. He was one of the youngest people to receive their Lifetime Achievement Award. He was referred to as the Pappy of Rum by bourbon historian and rum author Fred Minnick. Richard has been named Rum Producer of the Year 3 out of the last 4 years by the IWSC, that's the International Wine and Spirits Competition, and 4 out of the last 4 years by the International Spirits Challenge, or the ISC. So Foursquare currently produces a number of different rum brands. The exceptional casks in particular, however, are rare and limited one-off releases. These are hand-selected by Richard, the barrels are emptied, they are bottled, and they are shipped off, and when they are done, they are done. So whatever you find on the shelf today is rare, limited, and special. You may not ever see it again. Richard tends to use a combination of two different stills, and we would refer to this as being a single blended rum. And that's because we're coming from a single distillery, Foursquare Rum Distillery. It's gonna be a blend of rums between both the pot and the traditional twin column coffee still, and then they are blended together. So you're using both types of stills, which are 17th and 19th century technologies, and blending them together at a single distillery, a single blended rum.
Single blended rum.
Single blended rum. Single blended rum.
And this is where we get into the most beautiful and amazing part of Caribbean rum making. When you age rum in the Caribbean, specifically in Barbados, you have a very unique climate. This tropical climate induces very high evaporation rates, between 4 to 8% evaporation per year. And that means that over the course of a life cycle of a rum, let's say it's a 10-year rum just for ease, you will have had 40 to 80% of that rum evaporate. Now, we all know about the angel share, which is very common and commonly referred to in whiskey production, but the angels will take a much smaller proportion from the barrels. So we like to say that in the Caribbean, you have the Duppy share, and Duppy is the name of a very thirsty ghost who turns out to be much thirstier than the angels. So in some cases, you will have a blend of these two different stills put into barrel and set to age. Beyond that, we then look at all the types of barrels, all aging at different rates with different blends of rum in them. All of these barrels impart unique and different character. Everything from ex-bourbon barrels to ex-Madeira barrels, ex-sherry barrels, ex-Calvados, port, Zinfandel cask, you name it. Some of these releases are what we call double maturations, and that's way different than what we would say is a finish. With a finish, you're spending maybe 3 to 6 months, somewhere around there, in a secondary type of barrel. But when we talk about something like a double maturation, that means it's actually spending a majority of its time in that barrel type. In some cases, it might be 3 years in an ex-bourbon barrel. Those barrels are then emptied, and that liquid is then put into an ex-port barrel for an additional 6-7 years. So in total, that rum is 9 years old because it spent the first 3 years of its life in ex-bourbon and the next 6 years of its life in an ex-port cask. No sugar, no flavoring, no filtration, just rum. Each bottle has a mark number, and that relates to the number of release that that particular bottle is. They are big, they are flavorful, they are just bam, impactful. I mean, these are rums that are explosive in flavor. And so when people say,
oh, I don't drink rum, it's too sweet, I don't like sweet things,
I have to help them understand that most of the rums that they may have been tasting is somebody who's using back sweetening. So they're taking a finished product, essentially, after it's been distilled, aged, all of that, and then adding sugar back into the product. Because guess what? We as humans really like sugar. Foursquare does not have any sugar nor flavor additives. This is basically, Richard is adamant, really important. So every year, we as the importer, we get a number of different releases from Richard. We never know how many we're gonna get, nor do we know how much of it we're gonna get. But we always know that it's going to be some of the most exceptional rums, the exceptional cask selections, coming out of Foursquare. If you see one on the shelf, definitely get it while you can, because once they are gone, they will never come back. Some people would say that these are awesome sipping rums. I don't necessarily like to use the term sipping rum, only because I like drinking rum. Basically, any rum is a good sipping rum, as well as any rum is a good cocktailing rum. I don't like to differentiate between them. But I suppose if you are the type of person who likes to categorize things as sipping rums, then yes, these would make great sippable rums, especially considering there's no sugar added to them. These are as close to being an analog to a great scotch, or a great American bourbon or American rye. Whatever it is that you enjoy most in the world of spirits, I would say that these are up there with some of the very best spirits out there. I would not hesitate to put any of one of these in a cocktail, because just like great chefs will say a better ingredient will yield a better dish, I also believe that a better ingredient yields a better cocktail. And I know that's probably blasphemous to some people, and they're like, oh, how can you even put these rums in there? But I guarantee you, there's so much flavor in that rum, that flavor is going to stand up in whatever kind of cocktail presentation you create with it. So a huge thanks to Richard, to Foursquare Rum Distillery, to all of you for supporting. Really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to like and subscribe, and be sure to hit the bell so you can receive notifications. All of that is super helpful. And if you got questions, I would love to hear them in the comments below. Also, I'm gonna be doing my best to share the latest and greatest exceptional cask video here. And separately, if you want to learn about some of the other stuff that we bring in, be sure to check out these videos over here. Again, thank you so much. We'll see you next time. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's nice.